So, okay, now we'll understand it for zinc sulfate and lead nitrate. So, I am taking zinc sulfate and I am combining NaOH with it. Either ka plus, udha ka minus, you have to exchange the plus and minus among themselves, and then what you are getting is ZnOH twice plus Na2SO4. Got it? So, this is having a color. What is its color? It is white, but which type of white? It is gelatinous white. Gelatin type of white. So it is having a gelatinous white PPT. The earlier four which I explained you, here I have take the earlier four which I explained you like this: calcium 2 plus, Fe 2 plus, Fe 3 plus, Cu 2 plus. These four hydroxides are insoluble in excess of NaOH, but this ZnOH twice is soluble in excess of NaOH. So what I'll do now, I'll take this product ZnOH twice plus, again I'll combine NaOH. Why? Because I am using excess of NaOH, and then what we'll get is sodium zincate ZnO2 plus H2O. So you have to just go through this equation with excess of NaOH, then balancing and all you will do on of your own. I am not explaining you the balancing part. Explaining and all you have to do of your own. Then lead nitrate, similar way. Lead nitrate you will take, you will combine with NaOH. What you will get is lead hydroxide. This is having a white PPT. Which white? Chalky white. Then this chalky white PPT, when we use excess of NaOH, what we get is sodium plumbite and water molecule. Then whenever you are combining any alkali with ammonium salt, you have studied it in ammonia chapter. Whenever any ammonium salt is taken and any alkali is combined with it, what you get is ammonia gas. So ammonia gas is produced, water is produced, and a corresponding salt is produced. So this much is over. This table, you have to be thorough with it. What is generally asked is these two. These two are more important than other ones. These two are asked. For what? Zinc and for lead they are asking much.